हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड इन दैट चैप्टर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सम फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लाइक डिस्क्रीट फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड कॉन्टिन्यूअस और ग्रुप्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। ओके, एज वेल एज वी सॉल्व सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन ईच टॉपिक्स। ओके, now dear student, today we are going to discuss about the graphical representation of statistical data. Okay, today dear student, we are going to discuss about the graphical representation of statistical data. Okay, dear student, please listen carefully. In that type of representation, if we represent the any numerical data in the form of graph, there are three ways to represent the any numerical data in graphical representation. First one is bar graph, second one is histogram, third one is your frequency polygon. Today there are three methods to first one is bar graph, second one is histogram, and third one is, dear students, frequency polygon. Okay, frequency polygon. But in this year, dear students, the histogram and frequency polygons is deleted in your syllabus. So dear student, only we study the bar graph. Okay, now we discuss about the what is bar graph. Please listen carefully. A bar graph is a pictorial representation of the numerical data by a number of bars and means rectangle. We represent the bar as the in rectangular form as vertical and horizontally. Okay, and of uniform width, the bar of the width of the bar or rectangle is always uniform. Okay, erect horizontally or vertical with equal spacing between them. Okay, the equal spacing between each bar or rectangles. Okay, now each rectangle or bar represent only one value of the numerical data, means that each bar represent the only one numerical value of the given data. Now and so are the as many bars of the number of values in the numerical data, which is the number of bars depends upon our question which is given. Okay, now in order to draw a bar, now what is the process to construct a bar graph for any numerical data? Please listen carefully, dear students. In order to draw a bar graph, we draw two mutual perpendicular lines. First of all, we draw, dear student, two mutual perpendicular lines as OX and OY, that is called X axis and Y axis respectively. Okay, in order to draw a bar graph, we draw two mutual perpendicular lines in a plane paper. The horizontal lines called as x-axis, you know that very well, and the vertical lines is known as what? Y-axis. Okay, after that, dear student, if the bars are drawn vertical or horizontal line on x-axis, then the scale of height of the bars or rectangle is showing along y-axis. Okay, now dear students, some points is always kept in your mind when you draw any bar graph. So please write these points. Okay, dear students, while construction bar graph, following points should be kept in mind. The following point is very important. Important for constructing a bar graph. Constructing a bar graph. Okay, first one is, your first point is, the width of the bar should be uniform. Okay, the width of the bars should be
should be uniform. Should be uniform.
So this is one of the most important point when you draw constructing a bar graph. So first you see this, the width of the bar should be uniform. Second important point is that the gap between one bar and another bar should be uniform. Okay, the gap between one bar and another, the gap between one bar and another should be uniform.
Should be
uniform. This is also very important point in constructing a bar graph. The gap between one bar and another bar should be uniform. This is one of the most important point in constructing a bar graph. And last important point is there. Bar may be either horizontal or vertical. Okay.
Bars may be horizontal or vertical.
Horizontal or vertical. There are three important points always kept in your mind when you constructing a bar graph. First one is the width of the bar should be uniform. Second one is the gap between one bar and another. The gap between one bar and another should be uniform. And third important point is bar may be horizontal or vertical. So dear students, this is all points is very important in for constructing a bar graph. Now dear student, we take some examples, some questions based on bar graph. Okay, let's see.
Let's see a question.
Okay, now we take some question based on bar graph. Let's see, dear student. Your question is the following table gives the number of students, the number of students in class 9, in class 9th in a school during academic years 1996 to 2001, and your given data is first write as academic year, and second one is number of students in that particular academic year. Okay, so here dear student, we write as 1996 to 97 1997 to 98 academic year and 1998 to 99 1999 to 2000 and finally 2000 to 2001 1 2 3 4 5. There are 5 academic years here, and the number of students during that particular academic years are 50 75, okay, 125 150, and finally 200. Okay, now what is the question? Our represent the above data by a bar graph. Represent the above data, by a bar graph. Okay, so dear students, this is one of the most important questions of your NCERT exercise. Let's see once more time. The following table gives the number of students,
in a class 9, in class 9th in a school, okay, during academic years 1996 to 97 to 2000 to 2001, okay. Here the academic years 1996 to 90, here there are 5 academic years and the number of students in particular academic years are 50, 75, 125, 140, 150 and finally 200. And here now we represent the above data, we represent the above data by a bar graph, by a bar graph. Now for constructing the bar graph, just I discuss about that. First of all, we draw two mutual perpendicular lines as x axis and y axis. So first here we write now let's see its solution. Now let's see its solution, dear students. So here we write the information, and the academic year 1996 to 97 the number of students 50, and 1997 to 98 the total number of students is what, 75. During the academic year 1998-99 is 125. 1999 to 2000 the number of students is what, 150. And during the academic year what, 2002-2001 is what, 200. Now we represent the above data by a bar graph in this way. Let's see, dear student, in constructing the bar graph, in constructing the bar graph, first of all we draw two mutual perpendicular lines. Let's see, first of all we draw two mutual perpendicular lines as x axis OX and y axis OY. Now we take the academic year along x axis and we take the number of students in particular academic years along the y axis. Now in along the x axis we take the academic year, we take the academic year, academic year along the x axis, and we take the number of students along the y axis. Now let's see, dear students, so your first academic year is 1996. We generally we draw a vertical bar graph because of the vertical bar graph is very easy to draw and it is very easy. Now here the academic year, we take the academic year along the x axis and we take the number of students along the y axis. Now in that year we take the academic year, first academic year. Now let's see, so for first draw the number of students 50, first 25, we take the number of students along the y axis, so we take as 25 50 75, okay, 100. Now 125, now we take 150, now we take 175, finally we take as 200. Now the height of the rectangle or bars taking along the y axis, we draw the vertical bar. And now during the academic year 1996 to 97, okay, how many students there are in the class? There are 50 students, so we take a bar graph like that, okay. This is, now this information, this bar tell us about the information during the 1996 to 97 the total number of students in there in a school is 50. Now similarly we can draw the academic year, the another rectangular bar graph for the academic year 1997 to 98. Now 1997 to 98, during the total number of students are 75, so here we take as, and one important thing is that the width of each successively bar, the width of same, and the gap between the successively bar graph is also the same, uniform, okay. Now we take as 75, so we write in this way. Okay, the width of the bar is also same. So this is the during 1997, during 1997 to 98, the total number of students is 75. Total number of students is 75. Okay, during the academic year 1997 to 98, the total number of students there 75. Now similarly, for the academic year 1998 to 99, the total number of students is 125. So your bar is that, in this way we draw the bar for that particular academic year in this way. Your this academic this is the 1998 to 99. So during the academic year 1998 to 99, the total number of students are 125. Now similarly we draw in this way, we can, okay. Now during 1999 to 2000, how many students there in a school during that academic year? That is 150. So your bar is draw in this way, okay. This is the 1999 to 2000, and finally during the academic year 2000 to 2001, the total number of students during this academic year is 200, na? So we draw in this way, okay. During the academic year 2000 to 2001, the total number of students is what? 200. Okay, so dear students, in this way we can draw the bar graph of any numerical data. Here the numerical data is what? Here our numerical data is the number of students during a particular academic year is to be given, and we represent the given data by a bar graph. So dear students, this is the method to represent the any statistical or numerical data as a by a bar graph in this way. Now dear students, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on bar graph in this way. Okay, now we take some other questions of based on bar graph. Let's see the student next question. We take a question in that, this is the another type of question. In another type of question, one bar graph is to be given in your question, and according to bar graph, with the help of bar graph, you give the some answer according to question. Okay, now let's see that type of question. And your that type of question is, the following bar shows the number of vehicle. The following bar graph shows the following bar graph shows the number of vehicles passing through a road crossing in different time interval on a particular day. Okay, read the bar graph and answer the following question. Okay, now let's see the bar graph. first we, dear student, we make a bar graph and we find, we solve the question based on that bar graph. So that is along two axis, mutual perpendicular axis OX and OY. Now let's see here 0, that is 50, that is 100, that is 150, that is 200, that is 250, that is 300, that is 350, that is 400, and that is 450. Okay, now and 300. First, the first bar graph as 300, and the time interval, this is the number of vehicles, this is the number of vehicles taken along the y-axis, this is the what number of vehicles, vehicle, and this is the number of vehicle which is taking along the y-axis. Now in that along our x-axis, it is given that the time interval, that is 8 to 9 hours. Here 8 to 9 hours. Similarly, during this hour time interval, the total number of vehicle passing through that cross is, road is 300. Similarly 400, 9 to 10. It is also given that 9 to 10, this is 9 to 10 hours. The total number of vehicle passing through them is 400. Similarly, next bar is 250. That is 250. Okay. This is the hours 10 to 11 hours. 10 to 11 hours. Similarly, now 250 done. Now again 250 and again 50, 10 to 11 hours. Now 11 to 12. 11 to 12 also 250. This is also 250 during 11 to 12 hours. Now 150 during 13 to 14 hours. 150. During 12 to 13 hours, the total number of vehicle passing through them is 150. Okay, now 100, 13 to 14. 13 to 14, the total number of vehicle passing through them is 100. This is during 13 to 14 hours. Okay, now 14 to 15. The total number of vehicles passing through that is 200. Now 200 during 14 to 15 hours. Now 15 to 16 hours, it is 300. It is 300 during 15 to 16 hours. During 15 to 16, it is 300. And during 16 to 17 hours, the total number of vehicles is 350 during 16 to 17 hours. Now, this is the, dear student, this is the bar graph in our question. And your question is, the following bar graph shows the number of vehicle passing through a road crossing in different time intervals on a particular day. And you find, you just read the bar graph and okay, and answer the following question. First of all, you read the bar graph carefully. In that bar graph, we take the time intervals during along the x-axis during a particular day, take along the x-axis, and we take the number of vehicle passing through that road during a particular day take along the y-axis. Now your first question according to bar graph, based on bar graph, is what does the bar graph represent? Also give the maximum number of vehicle. Dear student, so your first question is, this bar graph, what does the bar graph represent? So you can say easily, this bar graph shows the number of vehicle passing through a particular time, different time intervals in the particular day across a road. Okay, this is your answer. And your next question is the same question is,
also give the maximum number of vehicles. Dear student, the maximum number of vehicle passing through a particular day is what?
400.
So this is your answer. Your first answer is that this bar graph shows the number of vehicle passing through a road during a particular interval of time, a day. Okay, and the total number of vehicle passing through that is 400 according to our bar graph. Now, our second question is, what is the hourly traffic maximum? Means, in what time of interval the total number of vehicle is maximum? So, dear student, in the time 9 to 10, let's see, during the time interval 9 to 10 hours, the number of vehicle is maximum in that particular time of interval, because in that time is for total number of vehicle passing through them is 400. So during 9 to 10 hours the total number of vehicle passing through them is 400. So this is your another answer. Now also give the minimum number of vehicles. So dear student, the minimum number of vehicle is what? 100. That during a particular time interval 13 to 14 hours. So all the information is in our bar graph which is given in your questions. Now next question is, when is the hourly traffic maximum? Your next question is, when the hourly traffic is minimum. During, dear student, the minimum number of vehicle passing through the road in which time interval? In time interval 13 to 14 hours. So our next question is, what is the hourly traffic minimum? So dear student, during the time interval 13 to 14, our traffic is minimum, that is 100. Okay, now your next question is, what is the total number of vehicle passing through a crossing during a particular day? So in that question you add all the number of vehicle passing through a particular type of interval in a particular day. You can add all means, so such that is 9 to 10 during the 9 to 8, 8 to 9 hours the total number of vehicle is 300. So 300 plus during 9 to 10 hours the total number of vehicle is 400 plus 400. Okay, now during the time interval 10 to 11 hours the total number of vehicle passing through them is 250. So we add 250 and dot so on. Okay, so this is, if you add all the number of vehicle passing through a particular time interval during a day, so you get your answer. Okay, so dear student, in this way you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on bar graph. So dear student, today we discuss about the graphical representation of any statistical data, and in that chapter we discuss about the bar graph. There are three ways to represent the any numerical data as a graph. First one is a bar graph, second one is histograms, third is frequency polygon. But dear student, in that academic year the histogram and frequency polygon is deleted from your syllabus. So according your examination purpose, only the bar graph is given in your examination. So today we discuss about the bar graph. What is the main characteristics of bar graph? What is the main point is kept in always in your mind when construct a bar graph? Okay, now today we solve two different types of question. First type of question is to give any statistical data, any numerical data, and according to given data we prepare a bar graph. And this is another type of question of bar graph, and in that type of question a bar graph is given and some question put in the based on bar graph. So you first read the bar graph very carefully and answer give each and now first you read the bar graph carefully, after that you can answering all the question based on bar graph. Now dear students, first you revise all the topic, all the section which we discussed in that class. After that you revise all the topic and solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on bar graph. Now in next class we discuss about the next topic of this chapter. Okay, now in next class we discuss about next topic of this chapter. Thank you.